हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज निर्मला फ्रॉम विवेकानंद एकेडमी ऑफ ह्यूमन एक्सेलेंस। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट क्लास 10 ज्योग्राफी लेसन नंबर 1 रिसोर्सेज एंड डेवलपमेंट पार्ट 2। एज इन पार्ट 1 वी हैव सीन डिफरेंट रिसोर्सेज एंड इट्स क्लासिफिकेशन। इन दिस पार्ट वी आर गोइंग टू सी क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ सॉइल्स। There are different soils. We have seen the importance of soil also. Without soil, we can't imagine any resource which will be available for us. In classification, first an important soil is alluvial soil. This is the most widely spread and important soil of India, which spread in whole northern plains. In fact, all the northern plain is made of alluvial soil. This has been deposited by three important Himalayan river system, the Ganga, the Brahmaputra and the Indus. These three rivers are very important in northern plains, and due to these three rivers, this alluvial soil forms. The alluvial soil consists of various proportion of sand, silt and clay. In different course of rivers, different types of soil you can see here. It is sandy soil, silt and clayey alluvial soil also occur. According to their age, alluvial soil is classified as Bangur, which is old alluvial soil, and Khadar, the new alluvial soil. These two different types of soils are there of alluvial soil. Old, which is far away from the bank of the river, that is called as Bangur soil, and which is new alluvial soil, which is near to the bank of the river, that is Khadar soil. Khadar soil is more fertile than the Bangur soil. Next comes black soil. It is also important. These soil are black in color and are also known as Regur soil. Another name for black soil is Regur soil. Black soil is ideal for growing cotton and is also known as black cotton soil, because in this soil cotton grows in plenty, or more production we get in this soil. It is believed that climatic conditions along with the parent rock are the important factors of the formation of black soil. There are different factors which are important for the formation of black soil, such as climatic conditions of any region, or which type of parent rock or bedrock is in the region. They cover the plateaus of Maharashtra, Saurashtra, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, etc. Third type of soil is red soil. These are derived from weathering of ancient metamorphic rocks of Deccan Plateau. As we know, in 8th standard we have seen the types of rocks: igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks and metamorphic rocks. So when these metamorphic rocks weathered, it cuts into pieces, then which soil forms? That is called as red soil. It gets in Deccan Plateau. Its redness is due to the iron composition. Iron is consist in the red soil, so its color is red. When iron content is lower, it is yellow or brown. The color of the soil, whether yellow or red, it depends on the consistency or content of iron. They cover almost the whole of Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Karnataka, Maharashtra and parts of Orissa. These soils are made up of volcanic rocks and lava flows. When lava flows, it comes on the surface of the earth and volcanic rocks form, and then when it weathers, these red soil forms. It is concentrated over Deccan lava tract, which includes parts of Maharashtra, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. It consists of lime, iron, magnesium and also potash, but lacks in phosphorus, nitrogen and organic matter. So maybe you know that when we take our soil for soil testing from the farm, you can see these in some soils magnesium is available, or lime, iron, potash is available, and phosphorus is not there, or nitrogen is lacking, or organic these matters are lacking. So farmers use this phosphorus or nitrogen from outside, which we call as chemical fertilizers. We give to the soil from outside, which is required for any crop. But for that purpose, we need to do first of all soil testing of our farm. Then we will come to know that these minerals are available in our soil and which we have to give from outside, that if we give, our crops will be production will be proper. Again, we will see about the alluvial soil, how these are important. We have seen previously that these are in northern plains, 2 to 3 rivers. This alluvial soil is in northern plains. They are grouped in old alluvium and new alluvium type. The so-called new alluvium may be even 10,000 years old. Locally, the old alluvium is called Bangar and the new alluvium is called Khadar. This Khadar and Bangar, two types of soils are there. Old, which is far away from the bank of the river, that is Bangar, and new, which is near to the bank of the river, that is Khadar. The old alluvium often contains kunkar nodules with calcium carbonates in subsoil. The new alluvium is richer compared to the old. Alluvial soils altogether are exceptionally prolific. In general, they carry ample potash, lime and phosphoric acid by water flowing over the floodplains. As if we see Ganga, the Brahmaputra and the Indus River, these rivers are flowing from the Himalayan mountains, so they are flowing from slopy regions, and that's why the water of these rivers have speed. In this speed, they bring different types of eroded material from the mountainous region, and that material they deposit on the plain land, and due to that these northern plains have been formed where this alluvial soil we get. Another soil type is laterite soil. These soils are formed due to intense leaching and are well developed on the summits of hills and uplands. They are commonly found in Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, Chhattisgarh and hilly areas of Orissa and Assam. Nearly the mountainous region, this type of soils we get. Arid soils. Arid soil is water deficient, as the soil is occupied by kunkar or nodular calcium carbonate, which restricts the infiltration of water. These types of soil is sandy soil, or water can't be absorbed in that soil. Arid soils are sandy in texture and saline in nature. In desert area, which types of soil we see, that is arid soil. Even common salt is obtained by evaporating the water. Arid soil mostly lacks humus and moisture, and thus evaporation is
very fast. It can't hold the water in it. Arid soil has that lacking, so it does not have humus and moisture also. So it is very, very free soil. The color of arid soil ranges from brown to red. Besides calcium carbonate, arid soil is dominated by secondary silica, gypsum, and soluble salts. When we have seen these different types of soil, this soil is degrading due to chemical waters, chemicals which are used as a fertilizers, as well as pesticides, insecticides are used in farming. Again, erosion has been done due to the heavy water or heavy rainfalls, sheet erosion, gully erosion we have seen. Then we need to conserve this soil. Conservation is also important because this is a most important resource for all our needs. Soil conservation is the prevention of soil loss from erosion or prevention of reduced fertility caused by overuses, acidification, salinization, or other chemical soil contamination. There are many reasons for the soil degradation, soil erosion. So it after the erosion the soil, it loses its fertility, and many of the acids we find in that soil becomes salinic, or many of the chemicals mixes in the soil and it loses its fertility. And then after, you will see that no any crop can be grow in that soil without chemical fertilizers. Slash and burn and other unsustainable methods of subsistence farming are practiced in some lesser developed areas. Still, many of the regions or underdeveloped regions are there. Those regions are following slash and burn type of farming methods. A sequel to the deforestation is typically large scale erosion, loss of soil nutrients, and sometimes total desertification. Sequel to deforestation means continuously human being is cutting the trees for his greed, for making the roads, making the buildings, houses, for the railway lines, to constructing the big buildings, or for the industries. Many of the reasons are there for that purpose. People are doing deforestation, and that is the large or most important reason for the soil degradation. Many of the places have desertified also. Techniques for improved soil conservation include crop rotation. So what are the methods or what are the steps we can take to conserve the soil? First one is crop rotation. We can sow the crops rotationally, cover crops. We can use mulching method for the crops, conservation village and planted windbreaks affect both erosion and fertility. When plants die, they decay and become part of the soil. Code 330 defines standard methods recommended by the US Natural Resources Conservation Service. Farmers have practiced soil conservation for millennia. So for farmers and everyone now has to use the methods of soil conservation. In Europe, policies such as Common Agricultural Policy are targeting the application of best management practices such as reduced tillage, winter cover crops, plant residues and grass margins in order to better address the soil conservation. Political and economic action is further required to solve the erosion problem. A simple governance hurdle concerns how we value the land, and this can be changed by culture. In this way, we have have seen the soil conservation, soil erosion happens due to many of the regions, and what are the steps that we can take. Or in this slide also you are seeing that soil erosion happens because of the upper layer of the soil. It changes due to the water, ice, snow, air, plants, animals and humans. Many of the reasons are there. How can we conserve this soil, which is very very important resource for our all the needs. In this way we have completed the lesson. We have seen people as a resource, then type of these resources, we have seen types of soils, we have seen in this second part. Read the lesson thoroughly, carefully, and write the main points or make the notes of the lesson, and be with studies. Thank you.